morning. My name is Erica Smith, and at 17, I became a soldier. In my seven-year career as a Black Hawk crew chief, I worked with many phenomenal people, and I deployed to Iraq in 2019. On the flights overseas, we were constantly watching for threats, but we didn't know about the silent threats we saw on a regular basis. Ponds of oil lit on fire, waste and garbage being burned, and the fuel and chemicals used on the aircraft. In 2022, during a spinal scan for a separate injury, a mass was discovered on my right kidney. I was just 23, with no family history of cancer. I ate right, I worked out, and I never smoked. Nevertheless, it was cancer, and it was growing fast. Shortly after, a friend from deployment let me know he had cancer in his kidney as well. I filed a claim with the VA immediately. Thankfully, the PACT Act reduced my paperwork burden, and it covered my illness. And by the time I had my kidney removed in October of 2022, I had already begun receiving increased benefits that helped me buy my first house. I'm so grateful for the PACT Act, and I encourage other veterans to take advantage of the benefits. The military gave me the courage to take risks, and the PACT Act gave me the stability to endure no matter the outcome. Now, it's my honor to introduce the President of the United States, Joe Biden.
Please, have us take a seat if you have one. Sarge, thank you for that introduction. You know, it's important for two reasons. One, I have been in and out of Iraq and Afghanistan over 38 times. And I don't think most people know, this audience may know, how many women we have in combat. How many women are not only doing their part, but doing jobs that most people didn't think women would do or could do. And the Sarge is an example of just that. You know, a Black Hawk helicopter is, anyway, I won't go into it all, but the point is that, you know, Sarge, what happened to you has happened to thousands of people. Governor and I talked about that earlier, the governor and I, about what we're doing here. You know, you and your fellow veterans are the heart, the soul, and the very spine and sinew of this generation. I mean, that's a fact. You know, only 1% of you volunteer to protect all of us. That's what it is. And it's all volunteer. And I want to thank Dr. Angela Williams and the great team here at Salt Lake City VA for hosting us, for taking care of our heroes. Mayor Mendenhall, thank you for the passport into the city. I appreciate that opportunity. And Governor Spencer Cox, thank you for your hospitality, but much more importantly, thank you for taking care of our veterans and for bringing along your beautiful family. And by the way, you know, years ago, just a little ad lib here, but years ago when John Kerry was the nominee for the president of the Democratic Party, he talked with me about the possibility of being vice president and on his ticket. And I wasn't, we're old friends. And I said, no, I didn't want to be vice president. But had I known that as vice president I get Secret Service, and had I known that meant my daughters had Secret Service and my granddaughters, I would have fought even harder for him at the time. And now, I have a bunch of grandchildren. They all have Secret Service, and my daughter has Secret Service, and, you know, it's just wonderful. I'm not sure what they think about it, but it's just wonderful. Anyway, thank you very, very much. And look, before I begin, I want to say a word about the devastating wildfires that have claimed at least 36 lives in Maui and Hawaii. We have just approved a major disaster declaration for Hawaii, which will get aid into the hands of the people desperately needing help now. They've lost, anyone who's lost a loved one whose home has been damaged or destroyed is going to get help immediately. And I've directed that we surge support to these brave firefighters and first responders and emergency personnel working around the clock there, risking their lives. I just got off the phone before I got here for a long conversation with Governor Josh Green this morning. Let him know I'm going to make sure the state has everything it needs from the federal government to recover. The FEMA Administrator Griswell will be in Miami tomorrow, in Maui tomorrow, and I've directed her to streamline any process with requests for help and survivors registered for immediate federal assistance without delay. FEMA is surging disaster assistance personnel on the island, and they're going to help survivors get access to federal assistance. And you know, anybody wants to know out there where to go if this is televised, that they can go to disasterassistance.gov, disasterassistance.gov, to learn if you're eligible for assistance. And I've ordered all available federal assets on the island, including the U.S. Coast Guard, the Navy Third Fleet, and the U.S. Army, to assist local emergency response crews along with the Hawaiian National Guard. We're working as quickly as possible to fight these fires and evacuate residents and tourists. In the meantime, our prayers with the people of Hawaii, but not just our prayers. Every asset we have will be available to them, and we've seen they've seen their homes, their business destroyed, and some have lost loved ones, and it's not over yet. But now, for the reason I'm here today. I've said it many times before. When I started saying it 30 years ago, I got criticized occasionally for saying it. I said, we have many obligations as a nation, but we only have one truly sacred obligation, and that's to equip those we send into harm's way and care for them and their families when they come home and when they don't. 1 year ago today, we met that sacred obligation when I signed, after fighting so damn hard for the PACT Act, to sign it into law. And I want to thank all the veterans organizations for helping make that happen, because it matters. The PACT Act is one of the most significant laws ever signed to help veterans exposed to toxic materials and help their families recover, as well as receive compensation. You remember what we mean by burn pits. You know, when we first started using the phrase burn pits, people kind of looked at us. But a burn pit is what you saw, basically, the giant burn pit. The first one everybody was aware of was a 9/11 when the buildings came down. Remember all those firemen that died of cancer and how they got covered? Well, when firefighters first responded, that's what happened. Now, the burn pits in Iraq, where we're talking about, and in other countries, Afghanistan, even in parts of throughout the Middle East, they're the size of football fields, up to 100 yards long, 20 yards to 30 yards wide, and 8 to 10.
Join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MACAD TV family. Please like and share MACAD TV. We love you all. Please support MACAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.